Hi, this is Dr. J. Suresh Gowd, Associate Professor in Department of Mathematics, Institute of Aeronautical Engineering. Today, we are going to discuss about the probability, the basic definitions of probability. Before going to discuss about the probability, we have to learn some basic concepts on probability. The first concept is, what is experiment? What is the meaning of experiment? How generally the students are doing experiments in physics and chemistry labs. What they are doing in the physics and chemistry labs, while they are doing the experiment, what they are going to observe, what is the student role while doing the experiment? See, while doing the experiment, they are measuring or calculate that particular experiment. How they are calculate is nothing but the process of measurement. And they are also observing the steps which are involved in that particular experiment. What they are observing means the process of observation. Either the process of observation or the process of measurement is called experiment. Only two things you should remember for experiment definition: either observation or measurement. Suppose if I take one example, counting numbers, counting 1, 2, 3, 4, that is also one of the experiment. Or counting traffic accidents. Suppose if I stand at signal point and counting accidents in a day, that is also measuring, na? That's why that is also called as experiment. Similarly, tossing a coin, also one of the experiment, or throwing a die, or counting the students in the classroom. All these are experiments, because this involved the process of observation or the process of measurement. That's why which is known as experiment. This experiment divided into two parts. First one, predictable experiment, and second one, non-predictable experiment. What is the difference between these two? What is the difference between predictable and non-predictable experiment? Only the small difference between these two. With example, I will explain you. Suppose throwing a stone upwards, it will definitely fall down to ground only. That means, while we are throwing the stone upwards, the result we can predict, it will definitely fall down to ground only. That means, the result we are predicted before going to do that particular experiment. Such type of experiments are known as predictable experiments. That means, the result can be predicted. Non-predictable means, the result cannot be predicted. While we are doing the experiment, the result cannot be predicted. Suppose tossing a coin. Example, if I take tossing a coin. If we toss a coin, or while we are tossing a coin, we cannot expect either head comes up or tail comes up. It may head or it may tail. That means the result cannot be predicted in such type of experiment. Such type of experiments are known as non-predictable experiments. This non-predictable experiments is also known as random experiments. The non-predictable experiments are also known as random experiments. That means we cannot predict the result. So like this experiment we divided into two parts. In probability concept, we require only random experiment. We are not discussing about the predictable experiment, because if you know the result, we don't want any probability for such type of experiments. If you don't know the result only, we require the probability. That's why in probability concept, we are considering only random experiments or non-predictable experiments only. The predict, what is the definition? An experiment is said to be predictable if the result can be predicted. That we have discussed in the previous slide. And non-predictable experiment or random experiment, the result cannot be predicted, like tossing a coin, throwing a die. In throwing a die also, either we can get it 1 or 2 or 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 faces. But we cannot expect the result while you are throwing a die. So, type of experiment is known as random experiments. Now, outcome. Outcome means the result of an experiment. Which type of experiment? Random experiment only. From now onwards, we are going to discuss experiment means random experiments only. The result of any experiment is called outcome. Suppose tossing a coin. This is tossing a coin. Is it random experiment or not? Yes, this is a random experiment because we don't know now. Either head comes up or tail comes. Suppose if you assume head, it may head. This is outcome, na? Because the result of this random experiment is called as outcome. Now, this is very, very important definition, sample space. What is the meaning of sample space? I will explain you with simple example, the same tossing a coin. Tossing a coin. First, we need to identify which is random experiment or not. It is a random experiment because we cannot predict the result if we toss a coin. In case if we toss a coin, what are the possible outcomes? If we toss a coin, either head comes up or tail comes up. Only two possibilities if we toss a coin. What my doubt is there any other possibility other than these two? No, because only two possible outcomes. If I make it this bracket, the group or the collection of all possible outcomes I written. The collection of all possible outcomes is known as sample space, which is denoted by capital S. The definition is the collection of all possible outcomes in any random experiment is called as sample space. The symbol of sample space is S, capital S. Now, for this random experiment, for this tossing a coin, how many outcomes, possible outcomes? Two possible outcomes. The sample space consists of two elements. I can write 2 power 1 elements also. 2 can be written as 2 power 1 elements. Suppose, if I take another example, tossing 2 coins at a time. Tossing 2 coins at a time. Not only single coin. If we toss 2 coins at a time, that is also experiment. Which type of experiment? Random experiment, because we don't know either head comes up or tail comes up. Suppose if we toss 2 coins, what are the possibilities? If we toss 2 coins at a time, the possibilities are the 2 coins may be head-head or HH. The 2 coins, one is head and another is tail. And tail head, first one is tail, second one head and tail tail. These are the 4 possible outcomes. Except these 4, there are no other possible outcomes if we toss 2 coins. So, if we make it the bracket, the collection of all possible outcomes I written. As we have discussed in the previous slide, by the definition of sample space, the collection of all possible outcomes is sample space. capital S. How many elements in this sample space for this random experiment? 4 elements. We can write as 2 square elements. So, tossing a coin, we have the sample space consists of 2 power 1 elements, and tossing 2 coins, the sample space consists of 2 square elements. Similarly, if we toss 3 coins, which is also random experiment, if we toss 3 coins, what are the possible outcomes? 3 coins are tossed at a time. If we toss, 3 coins are at a time. 3 may be head, T, H, T, H, double T, H, T, H, T, H, double T, and triple T. These are the possible outcomes. If we toss 3 coins, the collection of all possible outcomes, the collection of all possible outcomes is nothing but sample space. That's why which is denoted by capital S. So, the sample space consists of 8 elements. If we toss 3 coins, we can write as 2 cube elements also. Therefore, suppose tossing 1 coin, 2 power 1 elements in the sample space, tossing 2 coins, 2 square elements, tossing 3 coins, 2 cube elements. Like that, we can extend the formula, tossing 4 coins, 2 power 4 elements, and so on. In case if toss n coins at a time, where n may be any integer, the sample space consists of 2 power n elements. That point we have written, in tossing a coin n times, or n coins tossed at a time, both 2 versions are same. Tossing four coins at a time, or tossing a coin 4 times. Try to understand the concept, tossing 2 coins at a time, or tossing a single coin 2 times. Both versions are same. At the time, the sample space consists of 2 power n elements. Suppose tossing 5 coins at a time, the sample space consists of how many elements? 2 power 5 elements, that means 32 elements. Tossing a coin 10 times, how many elements in the sample space? 2 power 10 elements. So, like that, we can give the conclusion, tossing n coins at a time, or 1 coin tossed n times, the sample space consists of 2 power n elements. The same concept we can apply for throwing a die also. Suppose throwing a die. This is an experiment. Which type of experiment? Random experiment. Because we cannot expect the result of throwing a die. Either 1 comes up or 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 like that for faces. If we throw a die, what are the possibilities? What are the possible outcomes? Either you may get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So, these are the possibilities. Other than this, there is no other possibility. So, the collection of all possible outcomes, we can write as capital S. The collection of all possible outcomes, we can write as sample space. How many elements for this example? 6 elements. I can write 6 power 1 elements if we throwing a die. Suppose throwing 2 dice. Throwing 2 dice. This is also a random experiment. If we throw 2 dice, 1 die and another die, what are the outcomes? We know that die is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. and second die 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Six faces. Here also six faces. If we throw two dice at a time, either we can get 1, 1 and 1, 2, 1, 3, 1, 4, 1, 5, 1, 6 like that. 1, 2, 1, 3, 1, 4, 1, 5, 1, 6. Then starts with 2. 2, 1, 2, 2, 2, 3, 2, 4, 2, 5, 2, 6. Like that, 3, 1, 3, 2, 3, 3, 3, 4, 3, 5, 3, 6 and so on. Last one, 6, 1, 6, 2, 6, 3, 6, 4, 6, 5, 6, 6. Total how many elements? 36 elements. The sample space consists of 36 elements. We can write as 6 square also. Therefore, like tossing a coin, we can write the conclusion in the point 2. Suppose throwing a die. Throwing one die, 6 power 1, 2 dice, 6 square, 3 dice, 6 cube and so on. N dice are thrown at a time. The sample space consists of 6 power n elements. That is the point. In throwing a die n times, are n dice thrown at a time, then the sample space consists of 6 power n elements. That means 3 dice thrown at a time or 1 die thrown n times. Both two versions are different. 3 dice thrown at a time or 1 die thrown n times. The sample space consists of 6 power n. The sample space consists of 6 power n elements. So this is the concept of sample space. Now, event. What is the meaning of event? To learn this topic, event, we should know what is the meaning of sample space. What is the meaning of sample space? If you know the meaning of sample space means the collection of all possible outcomes. The collection of all possible outcomes. Out of all possible outcomes, the subset or the part of this sample space is called an event. The subset or the part of sample space is called an event. That subset should be non-empty. So, the event definition is a non-empty subset of a sample space is called an event. I will explain with the example. Same tossing a coin. This is random experiment. The sample space consists of H, T because tossing a single coin, possibilities are H, T. Suppose if I define A getting a head, it's my assumption. Assumption. So A can be written as H only because I define A is getting a head. Now you observe A and S. A is a part of S. Yes or no? A is a part of S or subset of S. So, the subset of S, sample space is S, na? The subset of S is called as event. Therefore, here A is event only. Instead of A is getting head, if I take B is getting tail, this is my assumption. I define B is getting tail. This is assumption. So B can be written as getting tail means B equal to T. This B also subset of S or part of S because S equal to H, T. So B is also event. So therefore, event means the subset of sample space, a non-empty. It should not be empty. It should not be empty. A non-empty subset of A sample space is called an event. So B is getting 10, B equal to T, B subset of S. So A and B are events. So event definition is the subset of non-empty subset of sample space is called event. Suppose if I take one example for event, throwing two dice means random experiment, and the sample space consists of like this 1, 1, 1, 2 and so on, 6, 6, totally how many are there? 36 elements we can write as 6 square. The sample space consists of 6 square. Now I am going to define getting sum is 11. Sum is 11. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This is the first die. Second die, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This is die 1 and die 2. Two dice are taken because throwing two dice. I defined getting sum is 11. Where you get sum is 11? Suppose if you start with 1. 1 if you add with 1. 1 plus 1 sum is required. Na? 1 plus 1 2 only. But sum is 11 required. 1 with 2 3 only. 1 with 3 4 only. 1 with 4 5 only. Add them. So if you take with 1, we are not going to get 11. Like the 2. 2 you add with any one of this die 2, also we are not going to get 11. Like that 4, 3. So 5, 6. 5 plus 6 is 11. Next 6 plus 5 is 11. So only 2 options are there. So A equal to 5, 6, 6, 5. So this A is also subset of S, because 5, 6 and 6, 5 is in a sample space only. Now getting sum is 7. B starts with 1. 1 if you add with 6, we are going to get 7. Na? 1 plus 6, 7. Similarly, 2, 5, 3, 4, 4, 3, 5, 2, 6, 1. Add all these terms, we are going to get 7. So B is also subset of S, because these all values included in the sample space. Now getting sum is 4. C starts with 1. 1 if you add with 3 only, we are going to get 4. Next 2, 2, 2, 4, next 3, 3, 1. Then 4 is there in the first die, but there is no 0 in the die now. That's why 4, 0 is not acceptable. So C is also subset of S. So therefore, A, B and C are events. So finally, we got it, are clearly understood that event is a subset of a non-empty subset of a sample space. Here we have two note points. Pi means nulli. There is no elements in that one. E is also subset of S. And S is sample space. S is itself a subset of S, which is known as sure event or certain event. The null event or impossible event. Because why we can call as impossible? It's not at all possible. Because event definition is non-empty subset. But I have taken empty subset. So that's why it is impossible event. Similarly, S is a sample space. This S also sample space. S is subset of S. It's compulsory required, na? Compulsory event. That's why, which is known as sure event or certain events. So pi is subset of S and S is subset of S. This is called impossible event or null event. This is called sure event. Or in the previous session, we discussed what is event. Event means subset of sample space. Subset of sample space. This event we are going to divide into 5 parts. The subset of sample space we are going to divide into 5 parts. First one, exhaustive event, mutually exclusive events, equally likely events, dependent and independent events, and favorable events. Now we are going to discuss each event with examples. First, we are going to discuss what is exhaustive event or exhaustive events. In any random experiment, the total number of or the total possible events are known as random experiment. Suppose if I take with example, this is random experiment, tossing a coin. The same example we are going to discuss with all the events. If we toss a coin, the sample space consists of H, T. This is, we know that. What is the meaning of sample space? The collection of all possible outcomes. Suppose if I define A and B, two different events. A, I am going to assume getting hat, and B, I am going to assume getting tail. So, A equal to H, B equal to T. I choose in two events, getting head and getting tail. What my doubt is there any other event other than head and tail? Not at all possible. So, total events are only getting head and getting tail only. So, the total events in any random experiment is called exhaustive events. So, A and B are exhaustive events. Because the total number of events are only A and B for this example. So, exhaustive events means the total number of events in any random experiment is called as exhaustive events. Now, mutually exclusive events. This event, we know that subset. Up to here, we have clear idea. Event. What is mutually exclusive? That means two events cannot happen simultaneously. Cannot happen simultaneously. Such type of events are known as mutually exclusive events. That means if one is doing or one is working, second one is not going to work. If second one is working, the first one is not going to work. So both two events cannot happen simultaneously. Such type of events are known as mutually exclusive events. Suppose if I take the example, same example, random experiment. Tossing a coin, the sample space consists of H, T because all possible outcomes. And I choose in two events, A equal to H, B equal to 2. Only the two possibilities if we toss a single coin, either head comes up or tail comes up. Now, what my question is, if we toss a coin, if head comes up, the tail doesn't come. Only one chance is there, either head comes up or tail comes up. But both cannot happen at a time because it is only single coin. When we toss a coin, either head comes up or tail comes up. So, both head and tail cannot happen at a time. So, these two events, getting head is A, getting tail is B. Both cannot happen simultaneously. That's why these two events, A and B, are mutually exclusive events because A and B are cannot happen simultaneously. So, this is the concept of mutually exclusive events. In case if A and B are mutually exclusive events, the common point between them is pi. There is no common point between them. Suppose A equal to 1, 2, 3. Like this I define. B equal to 4, 5, 6 I define. Now, I want A intersection B. This is A, this is B. Is there any common point? No. There is no common point, which is called pi. That's why these two are called mutually exclusive events. In case if any two events are mutually exclusive events, directly we can write as A intersection B is pi. That means there is no common point between them. not only two events. If I consider three events, A, B, C. In case if these three are mutually exclusive events, then consider any two events, pi. Similarly, these two events, B intersection C also pi. Like that, C intersection A also pi. There is no common point between any two events if we consider three mutually exclusive events. See, this is A, this is B. C, if I take 7, 8, 9. Now you observe A intersection C, pi. B intersection C, pi. And A intersection B also, pi. So, like that, multiple events are there. In the first case, we have only two events. And in the second case, we have three events. And in the third case, multiple events, n events, A1, A2, A3, like this. A1, A2, A3, A4, A5, like this. AN. The previous is AN minus 1. Multiple events are there. All are mutually exclusive. Means, consider any two events. A1 intersection A2 also pi. Like that, A2 intersection A3, pi. Like that, A1 intersection AN, also pi. Consider any two events, their intersection also pi. Simply, we can write as, for the group of elements from A1 to AN, AI intersection AZ equal to pi, where I not equal to j. So therefore, what we have concluded in this slide, A intersection B is pi. If you have two events, three events, A intersection B equal to pi, B intersection C equal to pi, C intersection A equal to pi. For any events, AI intersection AJ also pi. That means there is no common points between any two events if they are mutually exclusive events. Suppose if I take one example for mutually exclusive events, we'll see. Consider any experiment of rolling two dice. We know rolling two dice. If we throw two dice or rolling two dice, we know the sample space consists of 6 square elements, 36. That 36 also you know. What are the 36 elements? 1, 1, 1, 2, 1, 3, 1, 4, like that. 2, 1, 2, 2, 2, 3, 2, 4, 2, 5, like that. 6, 1, 6, 2, and so on. 6, 6. The sample space consists of 36 elements. If you count all these, we are going to get 36. Now define two events. I define two events. Sum of score is 6, getting 4 on first die. See, two dice, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This is the first die, die number 1. Die 2, also same faces, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Two dice are thrown. The sample space consists of 6 square elements. A and B, two events are given. A is sum of score is 6. B is getting 4 on first die. Then we need to show that A and B are mutually exclusive events. First, we need to define A. A is sum of score is 6. If we throw two dice at a time, the sum is 6, starts with 1. 1 if you add with 5, we are going to get 6, 1, 5. Next, 2, 4, 3, 3, 4, 2, 5. This is even because sum of score is 6. In this case 6, in this case 6, in this case 6, in this case also 6, like that. The last one also 6. I defined A. because A is defined that sum of score is 6. Now you define B. What is B? Getting 4 on first die. First die should be 4. This is fixed. First die should be fixed 4. What about second die, sir? Maybe any value from 1 to 6. So that options you write. 4 comma 1, 4 comma 2, 4 comma 3, 4 4, 4 5, 4 6. Here in this possibilities, you check it each case. The first die is 4 only, but the second die may change from 1 to 6. So, two events are defined. After defining these two events, what we need to show? We need to show that A and B are mutually exclusive. We know that if A and B are mutually exclusive, A intersection B is pi. That means there is no common point between them. But observe that here A 4 comma 2 and B also 4 comma 2. There is a common point in A and B. That means A intersection B not equal to pi, because there is a common point which is 4 comma 2, 4 comma 2. So that's why here A and B are not mutually exclusive events. The description here we have written S equal to 36 elements totally from 1 comma 1 to 6 comma 6. A defined and B defined. A should be not equal to pi. So therefore these two are not mutually exclusive events. So, three definitions completed as of now. Three types of events. One is exhaustive. Second one is mutual. Only two completed. Now, third one. Equally likely events. Any two events are said to be equally likely events if they have equal chance of happening. The chances of getting two events are equal, then such type of events are known as equally likely events. Suppose tossing a coin. The sample space consists of H, T. The same example I taken, getting head A equal to H, getting tail B equal to T. See, if we toss a coin, the chance of getting head is always equal to the chance of getting tail. So, they have equal chance of getting either head or tail. So, that's why A and B are equally likely events. Equally likely events. Now, fourth, dependent and independent events, which is very, very important. Two events, A and B, are said to be independent. Independent event. That means A and B are not dependent to each other. A is not affected by B and B is not affected by A. Otherwise, the two events are called as dependent events. I'll explain you with example. See, consider a box. This is the box. Of different color balls in that box. Red, green, blue, yellow. Here, in this box, we have different type of color balls. Red color balls, green color balls, blue color balls and yellow color balls. I am going to choose two balls from this box. First, I will choose one ball, then later one ball. First, I draw one ball, then later another ball. Okay? Right. If I choose one ball from this, that means first draw or first event completed. I choose one ball from this. Assume that it is green. Not exactly green, but you assume that green. So, one event is over. Now, draw the second ball, that is B. Before going to draw the ball, this one I replaced. Before draw the second ball, I replaced the first ball. So, what happened for these two events? is the event B affected by A? Not affected, because replaced. That's why A and B are independent events. That is case one. If the balls are replaced it before drawing second ball, then the second draw is not affected by the first draw. Our second event is not affected by the first event. Then these two events are called as independent events. In case, the same example, if the balls are not replaced, first I draw one ball and drawn another ball, but ball, the first ball is not replaced. Is there any affected? B is affected by A? Yes, because that green ball will not come. Before going to draw the second ball, we know that green ball will never get. That means the event B is affected by A. So the event, one event is affected by another event, means they are dependent. So A and B are dependent events. So if the ball is not replaced, then the second draw is affected by the first draw. And the two draws are called dependent events. I think you understood clearly the difference between dependent and independent events. Independent means not affected. Dependent means affected. Now, the last event, favorable event. Favor to particular event. The events which are favorable to one particular event in any random experiment is called as favorable event. I'll explain you with example. Suppose throwing a die. This is random experiment. Everyone know that, because the result cannot be predicted. The sample space consists of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now I am going to define A, B, C, E. Four events I take. A is getting 2, B is getting 4, C is getting 6, E is getting even number. Four events are taken, A, B, C, E. Observe that A, B, C, three events are related to this particular event or not? Yes, because this is E is even number. A, B, C is also even numbers. So these three events which are related to capital E or which are favorable to capital E. So A, B, C events are known as favorable events. Suppose if I take one more event, F is getting odd number. Now my question is, are they, A, B, C, are favorable to F? No, not favorable to F. Getting odd number is F and A, B, C's are three different events. Are they favorable to capital F? Not, because they are favorable to even number, not odd number, because they are 2, 4, 6. That's why these three events are known as not favorable to particular event F. That favorable concept or not favorable concept depends on particular event E or F. So therefore, the favorable events are known as which are favorable to one particular event in any random experiment. Unfavorable or not favorable events are also known as values for particular event. This favorable concept or not favorable concept depends on the particular event only.
Like, share and subscribe. Hit the bell icon for more updates.